Good morning, Wanda Fay here. It's Friday, February 23rd, 2018. Hope you're doing well. Lord, we just thank you for this day and thank you for this day. Let's get over here to Psalm 111. Praise ye the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart. In the assembly of the upright and in the congregation, the works of the Lord are great, sought out of all them that have pleasure therein. His work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endureth forever. He hath made his wonderful works to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. He hath given meat unto them that fear him. He will ever be mindful of his covenant. He hath showed his people the power of his works, that he may give them the heritage of the heathen. The works of his hands are verity and judgment. All his commandments are sure. They stand fast forever and ever, and are done in truth and uprightness. He sent redemption unto his people, Jesus. He hath commanded his covenant forever. Holy and reverend is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endureth forever. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Matthew 23. Let's just read a little bit of the word here in the gospel, okay? Then spake Jesus to the multitude and to his disciples, saying, The scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. All therefore whatsoever they bid you observe, that observe and do, but do not ye after their works. For they say, and do not. For they bind heavy burdens, and grievous to be borne, and lay them on men's shoulders. But they themselves will not move them with one of their fingers. But all their works they do for to be seen of men. They make broad their phylacteries, and enlarge the borders of their garments, and love the uppermost rooms at feasts, and the chief seats in the synagogues, and greetings in the markets, and to be called of men, Rabbi, Rabbi. But be not ye called Rabbi. For one is your master, even Christ, and all ye are brethren. And call no man your father upon the earth, for one is your Father, which is in heaven. Neither be ye called masters, for one is your master, even Christ. But he that is greatest among you shall be your servant, and whosoever shall exalt himself shall be abased, and he that shall humble himself shall be exalted. But woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye shut up the kingdom of heaven against men, for ye neither go in yourselves, neither suffer ye them that are entered to go in. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye devour widows' houses, and for a pretense make long prayer. Therefore ye shall receive the greater damnation. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye compass sea and land to make one proselyte, and when he is made, ye make him twofold more the child of hell than yourselves. Woe unto you, ye blind guides, which say, whosoever shall swear by the temple, it is nothing, but whosoever shall swear by the gold of the temple, he is a debtor. Ye fools and blind, for whether is greater, the gold or the temple that that sanctifieth the gold? And whosoever shall swear by the altar, it is nothing, but whosoever sweareth by the gift that is upon it, he is guilty. Ye fools and blind, for whether is greater, the gift or the altar that sanctifieth the gift? Whoso therefore shall swear by the altar sweareth by it, and by all things thereon. And whoso shall swear by the temple sweareth by it, and by him that dwelleth therein. Father, I thank you for allowing us to get to know you. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, God Almighty, for your word and for you, and helping us to get to know you, God. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. We love you, and we give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. I pray over the people, Lord. We pray over our nation, our country. We pray over the children, Lord, in the schools and out of the schools, homeschoolers, Lord, their parents. Father God Almighty, we just lift up families and marriages to you today, Lord, and singles, loneliness. We take authority over school shootings and harm to children or teachers, parents, whatever, Lord. There was a young man that took two knives to school, I believe, yesterday, Wednesday, and slashed people. Father, we come against the rage and the anger and the self-pity that would produce somebody to harm others and blame their lives on others. We come against that selfishness and that evil and that self-pity. We cast it out. We cast a demon out of these people. In Jesus' name. When I read that story last night, I wanted to post it on my social media, and I was tired. I wanted to get to sleep because I don't get a lot of sleep, and I know I need to. Sleep is important, people. Okay? Don't stay up too late at night when you got to get up and do things, playing video games. Get your sleep, okay? I'm not telling you what to do, okay? But I just felt like the Lord was saying to me, the devil, this is the truth, the devil goes about roaming about whom he may devour. So, Father, we take authority over the devil roaming about, seeking whom he may devour, and we bind people latching onto him and his thoughts and his evil thoughts, and then carrying out his will of destruction. Father, we come against that devil in Jesus Christ's holy name. We bind every and all kind of evil that he would try to cause this day in people's lives. We cover us all with the blood of Jesus and the angels of God. Why do I say the blood of Jesus and the angels of God? Because Jesus Christ spilled his blood for us when he went to the cross. That's what communion is all about also. Communion. And so the children of Israel put the blood of the sacrificial animal on the doorpost And when the spirit of death went through right before in Egypt, right before God delivered the children of Israel out of the hand of Pharaoh, he instructed them to put the blood on the doorpost. And that spirit from hell, the same one that goes around destroying, he's invisible, people, okay? They make video games out of these things. Why if you can play a video game and have fun and watch a movie about death and the devil and horror, why can't you believe that it's true out of the Bible? It's not that hard, okay? If you can receive it as a child would receive these true things out of the Bible. I'm not preaching a sermon here, okay? I'm tired of sermons telling me ABC. Do ABC and then you'll have EFG. I am so tired of hearing these sermons. Self-help and use the Bible. No, I want to get to know Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm not going to criticize anybody else for what they do, but this ain't a sermon I'm preaching here, okay? So if you can believe a video game that Hollywood or whosoever made a video game, I'm not criticizing that, okay? I'm just saying if you can believe that, why can't you believe what the Bible says about the devil going around seeking whom he may devour? And what happens if you don't know Jesus Christ? You could have a tendency to listen to the devil. God is good and the devil is evil and bad, okay? It's as simple as that. That's why I like to talk about God's ability to heal. Because God don't want us to be sick. Okay. So, Father, I just thank you that we get to know you, Lord, and then you will lead us and guide us, and we will hear that still small voice, and we will avoid listening to the devil and carrying out his will of destruction and death and stealing, killing, and destroying whosoever he wants to do, whatever that task is he wants to do today. We bind him, we resist him, not only from our lives, but from others around us. Neighborhoods, neighbors, cities, towns, schools. We bind school shootings. We bind, see, I was just talking about with a friend the other day, yesterday, while we were driving somewhere. I was saying, you know, if somebody wants to go in their mind harm people, they could make it just not a suggestion for you to go out and do things like this, but they could make a knife out of a piece of wood. And then lo and behold, I read this story last night about on Wednesday, a kid took two knives and slashed up a bunch of people. And I pray for those people right now that might be trying to hang on to their lives in a hospital. We pray for healing, Lord. We pray for deliverance. We pray for the church to preach Jesus Christ and reality. Your church are starving, Lord. So help us all get into the Word of God on our own. And lead and guide people to the right church and deliver people out of the wrong churches. Deliver your people, Lord God Almighty, out of religion. Out of the duty to feel like, oh, it's Sunday, we have to go to church. Now, I'm not coming against that, okay? Don't get me wrong here. Don't accuse me. The devil is the accuser of the brethren. I say go to church, but ask God where you're supposed to go to church. And if he don't say go somewhere, then get into the Word of God on your own. And let's quit condemning people out there in the world that don't go to church, that God has not led them to a body. I know it says, don't forsake the assembly together as the day draws near, especially as the day, as some do. I am not, and I know others are not, forsaking the assembly. We assemble every single day with other believers online and off. He says, where two or more are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst. He says, if you come together, you know, you can believe on something he says, and it shall be done if you ask and believe and doubt not. You can agree on things on earth. Come in agreement with your husband, your wife. Cast the devil out early in the morning before he thinks about getting started with his destructive attacking ways. And believe that you have the power to cast him out. Resist him and he must flee. Believe that, okay? Believe it when you do it, because he must obey you. And ask God to fill you with his Holy Spirit. I thank you, Father, for filling us with your Holy Spirit, your love, your peace, your joy. And Lord, TGIF, thank God it's Friday, but you know, some people, they work on the weekend and Sundays even. We're not putting any day above another, Lord God. That's making an idol out of a day. But you do have your rest, and I feel like on Friday it starts coming. Rest on Saturday, you will never, we enter into your rest every single day because Jesus, you are the Lord of the Sabbath. But you never stopped making Saturday the day of rest. Even when whosoever made Sunday the day to go to church or Saturday. We are the church. We are now. We are the church. Each individual person is the church, God's body. Okay? The book of Acts. Father, I just thank you for this day, and I'm going to bring it to an end here, this little broadcast. And help people to put their eyes on Jesus Christ, not man, not me, not anything. And people lighten up. I used to enjoy football, and hopefully I will again, but I don't make a god out of it, but it was kind of like a fun thing to do on Saturday. But you know what? It's okay. I love the patriotism. I love the patriotism of the Olympics. And you know, we used to enjoy the Olympics and go, oh man, all right, USA, USA, USA. And then some of us patriots were started to be labeled by the liberals as like fanatics or whatever, you know, Bible, guns and God and you know, patriotism. They kind of put the lights out on the patriotism of the Olympics, you know. And you know, we used to not hate Russia. And yeah, Russia, you know, I've prayed about Russia, okay? God convict Russia for their election meddling. We bind them. That's just the devil behind the scenes causing trouble, okay? And then what happened is the Democrats, they used that and they did exactly what the Russians wanted us to do. Get us fighting and perpetuate it. We'd like a little breather, please, so we can get back to life. Because when my country's hurting, I'm hurting, and I can't get on with possibly other things that God has me do in life. It's a little bit hard when the house is a mess. It throws me off, okay? So I'm not going to give up on America. I'm going to be patriotic. I'm going to be political, but I'm not called an activist because I don't, that from the 60s, that rings a liberal bell to me. And I thank God God delivered me from, you know, marching in an anti, you know, Vietnam War parade or anything like that. Our troops needed us to be, hang in there with them. And yeah, there were a few people in the Olympics that they were like anti-Trumpers, you know. And some of those people didn't do that well. But there's respect for a president, especially when he's anointed of God, and you don't recognize it. But that's okay, you have your freedom. But it's just like, you know, it seemed like the athletes were like, there was no sense of, I'm not saying this about all of them, but they were saying, oh, they were so like loving their teammates and stuff like that. But it was like, where is our America backing our athletes? We used to go, oh, USA, USA, USA. You know, so I just want to say to the athletes, we're behind you still. And as people that love God and are supposed to love other humans, you know, I enjoyed watching the Russian skaters. Is that okay? I mean, NBC had no problem with, you know, saying nice things about the Russian skaters because they did good, okay? It's obvious they take ballet classes, and I love that about the Russians, because I used to take ballet and studied it, and the Russians used it as state propaganda. Don't rely on what I say. Do your own research. But that doesn't mean we hate the person, the athlete. Just because Russia screwed up, I'm not going to hate Russians. I'm going to pray for them. I'm going to pray for Putin. I'm going to come against the Russia meddling in our elections. Okay, I'm going to come against that. We bind it. And we bind it also so that the Democrats are not going to have an excuse to continue to target our president. Thank you, Father, for this day. We lift up our president to you and our leaders. Homes and schools and businesses and highways and byways, skyways, protect. God bless America, and God bless and touch people around the world that they may know Jesus Christ also. Thank you, Father, for this day. We love you. We give you all the praise and glory. Have a great day, everybody. God bless you and strengthen you and lead and guide you, give you wisdom. Provide every need. Heal every hurt. Heal every hurt. Heal bodies, Lord. Heal, heal, heal. And we love you and give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus Christ's holy name, amen. Okay, everybody, have a really good day, okay? God bless and have a great weekend, okay? Hug your families. Love you. Bye-bye.